Hey guys, so as you can tell by the title, today we're moving to a bit of a different topic. If you've tried to buy a Dodge Charger, Challenger, or pretty much any other car during 2021, you'll know that it's not exactly the same experience as it once was. New vehicles are scarce and very tough to find, and estimations for special orders are months away from delivery. The prices of used vehicles are also skyrocketing both at dealerships and private sales. This applies to almost any vehicle, but of course this channel is about Mopar, so we'll be focusing on Fiat Chrysler or Stellantis brands. The cause of all this is because of a microchip shortage, so we'll go deep into the issue, looking at what's going on, how all of this happened, how Stellantis and other brands are affected, what companies are doing to combat this challenge, what this means for those looking to buy or sell your car, and how long this will last. So let's get right into it. So the first thing to address is the microchip shortage and what's going on. At the moment, there is a global semiconductor chip shortage. A semiconductor chip is an electric circuit with many components such as transistors and wiring, and it sits between a conductor and an insulator. These are commonly used in the development of electric chips, computing components, and other devices. The semiconductors are an essential part of many of the electronic devices in today's new vehicles. They're found in the infotainment modules, engines, driver assistance features, and fuel management systems. Experts say that there can be upwards of 50 of these semiconductors in each new vehicle today. Of course, with the shortage, auto manufacturers are having trouble getting enough of these chips, and that's kind of the source of all these problems. Just to put it into perspective, a shortage of auto semiconductor chips could impact nearly 1.3 million units of global light vehicle production in the first quarter, according to data firm IHS Markit. So that's a lot of vehicles that otherwise would have been produced that aren't being simply because of this shortage. So next, let's look at how this happened. First off, the early waves of the pandemic forced many auto factories and dealerships to close in April and May of 2020. Now, the US rebounded in the second half, some countries are in more dire situations and things were different across various regions across the world, but even with that rebound, sales still fell from an average of 17 million vehicles over the past 5 years to just 14.57 million in the US for 2020, overall representing a 14.6% drop. During those few months of being shut down, automakers across the globe rushed to scale down production, which included dialing back their orders of the semiconductors. Now, at the same time, many of us were headed into lengthy lockdowns, and whether you needed devices for working at home or trying to pass the time, consumers totally stocked up on laptops, smartphones, gaming consoles, and other electronic products during the pandemic, leading to less inventory. One example of this was with the PlayStation 5 and Xbox Series X, driving prices way up and making products scarce for months. The problem is, all of these devices also need semiconductor chips, so this strained supplies. Auto sales rebounded quicker than expected, so the car manufacturers were competing with the consumer electronics industry for these chip supplies. And for the manufacturers of those chips, it takes about 24 weeks to repurpose the lines and pivot from making electronic chips to those for vehicles, so the automakers began running short. And 24 weeks is around 6 months, so that's a long time for these companies to pivot and start making those chips. Then things got even worse. There was a fire at the factory of Japanese chipmaker Renesas Electronics in Hitachinaka, Japan, damaging 17 machines and burning down an area of 6,458 square feet. It took them a month and a half to resume half of the production capacity, and won't be until the end of May, over 2 months after the fire, that the full production was expected to resume. This company accounts for 30% of the global market for microcontroller units that are used in cars, so this was a huge blow to many auto manufacturers. On top of that, the severe winter weather and unexpected storms in Texas forced Samsung Electronics Co., NXP Semiconductors, and Infineon to temporarily shut down their factories in Austin, Texas. Infineon and NXP are major automotive chip suppliers, so of course this added to the shortfalls. Then there were sanctions against some Chinese tech companies, which just added to the chip crisis. Other manufacturers simply can't keep up with the demand as they underinvested in the inventory and raw materials that are necessary to make these chips. Demand for the electronics coupled with the new vehicles were faster and more than they anticipated, resulting in further delays. And all of that doesn't take into account any potential pandemic-related delays or outbreaks of cases within each workplace. So now let's take a deeper look at how Stellantis is being affected. Production either was or still is being stopped or slowed at over 6 different Stellantis plants, including 5 of them in North America. production either was or still is being stopped and slowed at 5 different Stellantis plants just in North America alone. The Jefferson North Assembly plant in Detroit, Michigan produces the 2021 Dodge Durango and 2021 Jeep Grand Cherokee. Layoffs started April 26th, and those continue until at least the end of May. Normally, there are 3 crews working 10-hour shifts 6 days a week, and that will go down to 1 crew for 3 weeks, and then the other 2 crews come back while the original one is laid off. The Warren Truck Assembly Plant in Warren, Michigan builds the popular Ram 1500 Classic, so the plan there is to continue producing the trucks without all the parts, and they will slowly be completed and shipped to dealers as the chips become available, so there's going to be a shortage of those vehicles as well. The Belvedere Assembly Plant in Illinois was shut down on March 29th, and it stayed that way throughout April, laying off all 3,600 workers. That plant produces the Jeep Cherokee. The Toluca Assembly Plant in Mexico builds the Compass SUVs, which is another one of the brand's top sellers, and production was stopped there as well. Moving to Canada, the Windsor Assembly Plant was shut down on March 29th for 4 weeks, but it will now be closed for at least 7 weeks total until May 17th due to the microchip shortage, and it could be closed even further beyond that. That plant manufactures Chrysler Pacifica and Voyager minivans. Another plant in Brampton, Ontario was also idled, stopping production of the 2021 Dodge Charger, Challenger, and Chrysler 300. So all of these plants are shut down simply because there aren't enough microchips to finish all the vehicles, so it's a huge problem. And as I said, that doesn't take into account anything pandemic related, for example, workers getting sick. So we have an example of that as well, as the Sterling Heights Assembly Plant, home of the 2021 Ram 1500, saw 630 workers test positive or being in quarantine in mid-April, so that delayed production there in a different way. But again, that's not really the focus of this video. So now, mitigation tactics. What are companies doing about this? Of course, this crisis has affected many brands, including General Motors, Ford, Honda, Volvo, Volkswagen, and Stellantis, just to name a couple of them. It's truly a crisis. Volkswagen stopped production of the Jetta on May 3rd and the Tiguan on May 6th. Daimler and their Mercedes-Benz unit has seen their hours shortened for 18,500 employees. Ford expects the chip shortage to cut their pre-tax profit by $2.5 billion. GM has had downtimes on all shifts at least 3 of their production plants, and I can go on and on. It seems that the only one not caught off guard by all of this was Toyota, who made the decision to stockpile key vehicle components many years ago after experiencing the Fukushima disaster of 2011. There are some mitigation tactics to get around this, though, so many companies are changing the way they operate so they can continue production. First of all, these auto manufacturers are trying to shield the pickup trucks and full-size SUVs from the effects of the shortage as much as possible, as those are their most popular and profitable vehicles. Light passenger vehicles and smaller cars are the ones that will feel the most effects here with the reduced production. So the chips that would be used for those cars are now being used for the SUVs and trucks mostly. Sometimes though, that's not enough, so in order to produce these vehicles, other things have to be modified. Ram Trucks has changed many option packages on 1500, 2500, and 3500 trucks, such as eliminating blind spot monitoring and making the standard digital rearview mirror an upgrade instead. GM has taken a different approach and removed the cylinder deactivation from 2021 Chevrolet Silverado and GMC Sierra pickups that have the 5.3-liter Ecotec 3 V8. So that allows to keep the supply of trucks coming while they take a 1 mpg hit on the EPA ratings. Other Stellantis brands like Peugeot and Fiat are starting to build models with analog speedometers, so they won't have to use digital clusters that require several chips. And Nissan is building vehicles without pre-installed navigation systems. Again, those are just a few of the early examples, and if this continues, companies may go to greater lengths or stop production entirely. So the big question here is, what does this mean for consumers like you and I? Overall, across the globe, we've now lost out on 1.1 million vehicles, and automakers could lose as much as $61 billion in revenue because of the chip shortage. Again, focusing on the Mopars, dealerships in North America have been short on new inventory for models like the Dodge Charger and Challenger really since mid-2020. For anyone that's looking to buy one, first of all, the dealership probably doesn't have any left, and if they do, you can expect them to be very apprehensive to mark that car down or give you any price discounts. If you want to order a custom vehicle, the wait times are probably crazy long at this time as well. And the same goes for used vehicles. Without the new stuff coming in, dealers need to buy used to maintain their inventory. So they're paying top dollar for used cars, and then selling them, of course, for top dollar to make money on them. So that is some good news for anyone that owns a relatively new Charger or Challenger, as you'll find the value of your car is going up right now. But this isn't a great time to buy a Charger or Challenger if you're looking to score a deal, but it is a great time to sell if you already own one. Of course, as we discussed, this affects all the other brands and not just the Mopars, but it does seem that any vehicle that is more limited production, rare, or on the performance side are being affected the most. So, that begs the question, when will this crisis end and things kind of go back to normal? Well, only 12% of global semiconductor manufacturing is done in the US, and factories cost tens of billions of dollars to build, and expanding their capacity can take up to 1 year for testing and qualifying complex tools. US President Joe Biden is seeking $37 billion in funding for legislation to supercharge chip manufacturing in the US, and four new factories are slated to be built in the country, two by Intel Corp and one by TSMC in Arizona, and another by Samsung in Texas. Intel Corporation CEO Pat Gelsinger says that this shortage probably won't be resolved for a few more years, so many automakers are concerned about the second half of 2021 and even the first half of 2022 as they navigate uncharted territories with a lot of uncertainty. A reasonable answer would say that this dies down in the middle or end of 2022, so we've got a long way to go. So that's the end of this video. Hopefully you enjoyed digging into the microchip shortage issue and looking at how that's affecting the whole auto industry. Let me know what you all think of everything we talked about. I'm always interested to hear what you guys have to say. As always, make sure to like and subscribe for all your Mopar content, and stay tuned for more videos to come. I'll see you guys in the next video.